our current government. They hate this idea of a so-called socialist government that has things like Social Security and Medicare, Medicaid, food stamps, housing supports, low-cost education. I mean, all of this stuff. It's just they're totally opposed to it. And this is where America is at. So what do we do about this? How do we step back from this precipice? I mean, you know, when there's this shared sense of grievance, small things can trip off a big problem. So first, Americans have to trust that their democracy works. How do we do that? We roll back Citizens United, and we put into place an election system that is consistent across the country. Like Canada has elections, Canada, national standards for elections. Second, we have to, you know, basically help out the people of all races who've been the victims of 40 years, 42 years of Reaganomics. Other advanced countries do this by expanding union rights, expanding the social safety net, including free and low-cost medical care, free and low-cost college and trade school. I mean, when people have good jobs and income, they tend not to become terrorists. Our slogan should become, if Canada can do it, why can't America? And finally, and it pains me to say this as somebody who back in the 60s as a member of SDS was surveilled by state police and local police. But nonetheless, I think that the final step is that if we're going to avoid the possibility of a fascist takeover, as has happened in Russia, Turkey, Hungary, Egypt, and the Philippines, our state and local police and federal agencies need to start seriously ramping up their surveillance and infiltration of these domestic terror groups. America didn't ask for a homegrown right-wing terrorist movement. But now that it's here, we need to take it seriously. It's 15 minutes past the hour. We'll be back on it. Share with you some thoughts on the State of the Union address tonight, Biden's economic...